All right, so what does this have to do with function approximation or regression? So how does this notion of regression, of falling back toward the mean, have to do with this idea of approximating functions, mapping inputs to outputs? It seems kind of odd. So it turns out that the relationship is, here's the connection between them. So we're going to draw a graph, and on this axis will be the parent height, and on this axis will be the average child height. So if we plot these against each other, let me put the mean up here. Let's say that this is mean height for the population. And now say that we sort of imagine that parents of average height will have children of average height. But parents that are really tall, like that hypothetical person from before, will have children that are taller than average but not as tall as themselves. And similarly, people that are very, let's say, of smaller stature will have children that are also, short, and but not quite as short, again, closer to the mean. And it turns out that you have this very nice linear relationship between these quantities. And there's an important aspect to this, which is that the slope of this line is less than 1. It's 2/3, right? If the slope of this line was 1, what would that mean, Charles?
That would mean that everybody's children were the same height as their parents.
Right, right. And so that's exactly right. And so, but if the slope is less than 1, like it is, it turns out to be in real populations, then what's happening is the children are a little shorter than the parents. Children of tall parents are shorter than they are, and the children of short parents are taller than they are. And that's the fact that this is less than 1 is what makes it regression to the mean. Now, this was worked out in, I believe, the late 1800s, and it was just such a beautiful way of connecting all these different quantities together to kind of think of them as being related in this functional way that people said, oh, this is really great. I'm going to use this idea of regression. And what they started to mean, actually, was this not this idea of regression to the mean, but this idea of finding a mathematical relationship based on a bunch of measurements of points. So this term ended up getting misused, but that's the term that we have now. So regression now refers to not this idea of collapsing back towards the mean, but the idea of using a functional form to approximate a bunch of data points. Isn't that weird?
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
There's another example of this sort of idea where a reasonable word, like regression, which was referring to some physical thing in the world, due to experiments like psych experiments at this point, became this mathematical concept where the name doesn't really fit anymore. Like, there isn't really anything regressing in what we're doing. Mm-hmm. There's another really important example that we're going to get to later in the course. Do you know what I'm thinking of, Charles?
No.
So reinforcement learning is my field of study, and often your field of study.
Often.
Often. And it turns out that reinforcement learning doesn't mean what the words mean anymore, that this was a concept that the psychologists used to explain what they were observing. And then some mathematicians, well, let's call them computer scientists, took the word themselves, started to use it, and used it wrong, but now it's stuck. And regression is another example like that. The word is sort of being used wrong, but it's stuck, and that's what we're going to use.
This explains why every time I have a conversation with a psychologist about reinforcement learning, we talk past each other.
Yes, they get very confused. I try to tell them up front, that's not really what I mean, but I'm going to use the words anyway, but it still confuses them.